So Justin Gaethje recently said that he doesn't think Khabib is undefeated. He said he thinks Gleison Tibau beat him. For those of you who are maybe new to watching MMA, which is probably not that many of you, Khabib fought Gleison Tibau back in 2012. It was his second UFC fight. He was awarded a unanimous decision victory. All three judges scored the contest 30-27 in favor of Khabib. But the media, for the most part, felt that Tibau had won, including Joe Rogan.
He certainly was trying harder. He was certainly the guy that was pushing the pace of the fight. But I personally thought that Gleison scored more.
Fan opinion was divided across the middle, with slightly more fans scoring the fight for Tibau. So every year or so, this topic gets dredged up again with debate and discussion as to who really won the fight. And on the one hand, it's to be expected. Khabib has been dominant throughout his career, not only beating his opponents, but vanquishing them. And here we have one fight on his record where there is some disagreement, where many believe that his opponent won. This is MMA Dive. My name is Isa.
I jump in it.
I'm not going to bother talking about Nurmagomedov's growth as a fighter since the Tibau fight. This goes without saying. Nor will I qualify the discussion by referencing Tibau's PED suspension. We want to see this fight at its face value to assess it for what it was at the time that it took place. So on the surface, we can see how it stands out from Khabib's other fights. For one, he failed to take Tibau down, which is unheard of for Khabib, to not be able to take someone down. And that's pretty much it. Khabib failed to take Tibau down, and neither man was particularly active in the stand-up. In fact, in terms of strikes thrown, this fight was barely more active than Woodley versus Thompson 2. And that is factoring the difference in duration between these two fights. At this point in time, Khabib had yet to really tailor his game to the cage, to fighting in a cage. Up until this point, I believe he had only fought in a ring, aside from his UFC debut. And this shows in the fact that Khabib has Tibau up against the fence on numerous occasions but can't get him down. That just wouldn't happen today. Now, the stats certainly do not tell the story of a clear winner. Khabib threw slightly more strikes, and the two men landed about the same number of strikes. There was not much disparity between the rounds either, as far as the strikes and striking percentage are concerned. Neither man landed more than 10 strikes in a single round. So no, we're gonna actually have to go and watch this fight. I know, right? The first round was probably the easiest one to score. Very little action for either man. No particularly damaging strikes landed. But Khabib was the more aggressive fighter, attempting a variety of takedowns. In fact, for most of the final 2 minutes of the round, he was controlling Tibau against the fence while chaining together takedown attempts. Like here, Khabib goes for the single leg. He doesn't get it, but he keeps driving. Tibau still keeps his balance. Khabib gets his hooks in, tries a leg sweep, but Tibau pops right back up. So then Khabib goes for the outside leg reap and doesn't get it. He just kept chaining attacks together, trying to get him down, and Tibau just staved him off. All other things being equal, control and aggression can win a round. That's the judging criteria. That's how judges are supposed to judge a fight. And Khabib was clearly the aggressor here, and was controlling Gleison for a sizable portion of the first round. So I can't really see any argument for Tibau winning round one. The second round is where I kind of diverge from the official scorecards. I give that round to Tibau simply because he managed to take Khabib down. Although once again in this round, Khabib was the one pushing the pace and controlling the center of the octagon. It's a tougher round to judge than round one, but I gave it to Tibau when I saw it first, and I'm standing by that simply because of his successful takedown. In round 3, Gleison takes Khabib's back for a few seconds. But here's the thing, are we going to give Gleison credit for the back take, or are we crediting Khabib for getting out of it without being in any real danger? So for example, Kevin Lee had Al-Ai Quintus back for what seemed like an eternity in their second fight, constantly threatening the choke and landing some strikes as well. And this was done in 2 separate rounds, yet the judges gave Al that fight, 4-1. And nobody really disputed it. Al did win that fight. So I don't think that back take was enough to give Gleason the third round in and of itself. Especially when Khabib was continuing to push the pace, controlling the center of the octagon, and attempting more strikes than in any previous round. Tibau, the crafty veteran, was playing for points. Khabib, the young up-and-comer, was constantly pressuring. and even adjusted his game plan to adapt to the defensive Tibau. He attempted fewer and fewer takedowns, which had been fruitless up until that point, and attempted more and more strikes in each successive round as the fight went on. All in all, does it matter? No, it does not. It was not a very interesting fight. The only reason we still talk about this fight is because it's the only competitive fight on Khabib's resume. And as much as I respect the differences in opinion here, it's silly to go so far as to count this against Khabib's record. This isn't a loss. It's not even really a controversial win. The judges saw a close fight and gave the decision to the more active fighter. And that's it.